Okay, everybody, let's go ahead and get started. How's everybody doing today? Hey, what's up, Jimmy? What's up, Melons? What's up, SJ? I'll read those messages in a second. Just need to get my bearings here. I had to really drag myself to play this because I am really disappointed in what this ended up being. Star Wars, the classic collection of the Battlefield games, 1 and 2. These are games from when I was... I wasn't a teen. I was in my mid-20s when I first played these games. Let me go ahead and get on the screen. Let me go ahead and put it on the game screen here. Alright, so this is where we're at. Let's see what's going on. Star Wars The Badunkadunk Wars? Well, yeah, it looks like The Badunkadunk Wars. Hey friend, I just filled up a hangar and I have a bunker for Sunday as well as a casino heist. Okay, good for you, man. I know you're really trying to get your build up your bank account because you're low. Well, so good for you, man. You'll make quite a bit of money that day on Sunday. Let's see, Jay. Yeah, Star Wars. Yeah, well, that was a good thing, Jay. I thought this was gonna be a good stream. Luke, you killed my father, Darth Vader. No, Luke, I am your father, Luke. No, that's impossible. Exactly. DHC's off. Hey Maddox, how you doing, man? Oh yeah, that's another that's a completely different pot mess. That's completely different. So this game was a flop. Well, you're about to find out, Jay. It's not what we expected. Let's just say that. Let me just say the reason why I bought this game is because I wanted to like enjoy the multiplayer with friends. That was my goal. I've already played the campaigns. The campaigns are fine. The main thing that I was really excited for is to play this game online with friends. We had the EA version, which is like this one. And this one, when this one came out, Battlefront 2, Battlefront 1 and 2, they were garbage because they had a lot of monetization in them. They had a lot of crap in them. It took years for them to fix. Actually, this one is not playable. We might actually look at this one in a minute. That's why I put it on the front page. I do want to take a look at this one in comparison to Battlefront. But we're going to start with Battlefront first and see how the hell could they have possibly screwed up this game, man. This wasn't easy. I knew it was just going to be a port. I wasn't expecting a remake. I wasn't expecting a remaster. I'm not expecting this game to have high-quality graphics or fidelity or any of that crap. I only wanted a port that worked, that I could play online with my friends. That's all I expected. I was willing to shell out the $30 for it just for that. And they couldn't get that right. They completely fucked that up. The problem with this game, well, you'll see in a minute. Let me go ahead and start loading up in here. I'm glad you didn't pre-order too, Jim. Unfortunately, I made that mistake. That was my mistake. The superior one's Battlefront 2. That's the one I would really want to play online. Battlefield 1's okay too, though. But Battlefield 2 is the one where it's at. And like I said, I was in my mid-20s when I played this game. I barely had a Xbox. I think it came out, it was in 360 as well. But mostly, I think it was mostly on the Xbox. No, it was on the Xbox, actually. The original OG. The OG Xbox. And I was one of the few people that actually did have a connection to the online. So I did play this online. But at that time, I didn't have any online friends. So every match was like randoms and stuff. So I didn't really have an online presence at that time. This is 2005, 2006. This is the very beginning of online play. Not a lot of people had online connectivity at the time. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to crash the game. And I know exactly how to crash this game. Let's say you want to go into Battlefront 2 and you want to play multiplayer, right? And you don't want to just jump into any match. You want to jump into a lobby. And let's say you don't want to just play any mode. Let's say you want to play Conquest. Okay, let's go to Conquest. So you'll go and it'll say pick a session and boom. Your game crashes. It actually crashed a lot faster than I thought. Usually it takes like a couple of, maybe like 30 seconds to a minute before it crashes. But it crashes instantaneously when you try to search for a match. Let's just send that report in anyway. So you have in Battlefront 2, you cannot choose a match. You have to pretty much just roll the dice and pick a quick match and hope that it's a good match that has a good ping, that has a match type that you want, because you're not even going to be able to pick that. If you want to do Hero Assault, you want too bad. You can't select the lobby Hero Assault because it's going to crash on you. You want Galactic Conquest? Too bad. It might crash on you if you try to pick it. So that's the annoying thing, not being able to go in here on multiplayer, go to search, and search for a lobby. Like, let's say I want Hero Assault. Okay, so I'll sit there, and boom, again, it crashes again. That is annoying. How they could release a game like this, where you can't even pick the mode you want to play, is beyond me. $35 this game costs. And this is not something, like I said, this is not a remake, this is not a remaster. It's not like they've had to put a ton of effort into it. All they had to do is make it work. That was their number one job. Put it on console, make it work. And they failed. They failed miserably at it. So now if I want to play a multiplayer online, it has to be at random. I have to select a random match. And I won't be able to hook up with friends. I won't be able to do any of that stuff. I just hope that they'll be able to land in with me. You've been a Star Wars fan ever since you were... Exactly, same. Ever since I was a kid, too. With the original Star Wars, the original three. Those are the ones I grew up with. I grew up watching those three. And it pains me to see this game from... Not my childhood, because I was older. From when I was, like, really into gaming at that time. When I was in my mid-20s, that's when I really played... That's when I was really into gaming, especially when I started online gaming. I should hold on a second. I forgot to mute this real quick. So now I can, and you know what? Here's the other thing. I can't even pick what team I want to be. I got an auto sign. And I land on some random team on a random match that I think either we're losing or we're winning. I can't tell from here. I think I'm going to load in. Load me in. What the hell is this countdown? There we go. Alright. I don't even know where I am.
Command post under attack.
Let's jump. Let's roll.
Command post is now under hostile control.
Where's everybody? Let's shoot. Oh! I was about to shoot that guy and we just won. Well, yay, we won. That's nice, but I didn't get to do a damn thing. At least some of these people got to play. Well, it looks a little mismatched. Here's the other thing. Where's the button where I could get out? It's not here. It just says select. So I select. It's just to select people. But how do I get out of the screen? There's another little thing I noticed playing last night. So they haven't really fixed anything. I heard there was a patch, but I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything get fixed. Who's my favorite Star Wars character? I've always been I like Han Solo. From the here we go, finally done. Now I can pick done. It takes me a while for that done button to come out. And again, I just random lobby, random map, random. I don't even know what. I can't even pick my team. Auto assign. Let's see where I go. No, so I'm a rebel now. Just pick whatever. Now, of course, from the dark side, Vader. Vader is like the ultimate Sith. Well, at least I got the high ground. That's good. Here's zoom. Okay, here we go. Jeez, that was bad. I would usually play as a marksman, but let's see if it works out better now. Cause I don't mind sniping, but I really had a bad time sniping last night. Let me see. Cause the lag is pretty bad here too. But let me give it a shot. Since we're getting the high ground. Okay, I'll hit that guy. Whoa! He took me out of his. Oh, that's why. Because there was a guy here. I'm gonna get healed up. He almost killed me. There you go. Alright. Oh! Do I have another weapon? I zoom so slow to react. There he is.
We're taking heavy losses.
Come on. There you go. I got one. I barely. Oh, getting hit. Ah! Funny final hit. It's funny. That zoom back, it's really disjointing. Oh, yeah, and then the aspect ratio. Yeah, you're right. 4:3. It's really jarring, actually. I wish I had a reticle, but I don't. Let me just go regular. It's really hard to play as a marksman.
We control the command post. We're taking heavy losses.
What's that reload? Jeez. Looks like your gun just leaves and then comes back. Hey, Mark, how you doing, man? Whoa! Where am I? Where did this game spawn me at?
Losing
Ay, you got in my way, dude. Ultimates, what is going on in the chat? I gotta read in a second. Jeez. There we go, we destroyed it. Also, the explosion, whenever something exploded, it shakes the camera a lot. I mean, I guess it's cool for immersion, but you kind of want your camera a little steadier so you can see what's going on. Let me see, let me get to another. Oh, shoot, here we go. Wow, I couldn't hit that guy. Let's go to one. You know, I only play GTA once every 2 weeks when Pearl streams it. Oh, this would have been a good place to have the sniper, actually. Whoa. There we go. I got one. And then they got me. Let's see, let me try the sniper again. Hold on, where is he? There. It's a lady. I know that it wasn't the original, but I don't remember it being like this jarring. I don't know. Maybe I just have a rosier memory of this game. That's why I don't remember it being so jarring back in the day. Get out of the way, Chewbacca! Oh, shoot. Oh, that's one of ours. Never mind. I thought it was one of theirs. Here's the other thing. Isn't there a dash on this thing? Oh, there's one. Yeah, it's a reload. Oh, shoot. Ah! There we go. With no aim! With no reticle, I was able to kill him. That's pretty cool. Hard, but... Ah, damn. It's the other thing. You don't get any feedback when you get hit. I don't know when I get hit or not. I don't feel anything. No rumble, no nothing. That's the other odd thing, too. You just gotta keep an eye on your life bar. See, there you go. I didn't feel a damn thing. I'm just down. They should have added like a little rumble. Oh shit. Oh, here they come. Damn it. Where'd he go? Where'd they go? Oh, here he is. This is ours, though. This is our walker. We possess the walker. Oh, shit. Hit him. There you go. Where did I get hit from? Oh, we got defeated. See, the game is not bad. It's still good. It's just, there's so many things wrong with it. There's like, I need feedback when I'm getting hit. I don't know I'm getting hit until it's too late. Let me read some of the stuff in here. Let me see. Let's see. And then the respawn screen gives you... I know exactly, right? Because it looks like it flips around like 20 times over. Aren't you used to the camera thing? It happens whenever you just falls to the ground. Well, yeah. Manage, you know, it doesn't happen as often. Here, it's going to happen quite a bit. So it is a little jarring. You're not used to it. I never played the multiplayer as a kid, and I don't plan on playing it now. See, that's the thing. The multiplayer was the best part of Battlefield. I don't know. Maybe you don't like you never played it because you never had maybe an online connectivity. I did, so I did enjoy the online part, and it was fun for me. Even though I only played with randoms, it didn't matter because at that time I didn't know anybody online. Wrist rockets. Ah. Yeah, that shaking is a little jarring. I don't you like that awesome smoke in the background? No, I didn't want to zoom. Ah. There you go. Wrist rocket. Oh shit, what the hell? I got run over. Damn, that shaking is really getting on my nerves. Oh, that's what happens when I went head on. Of course, I was gonna get blasted. What is up with that screen right now? Jeez. Yeah, we get the hell out of the way. There we go. See if we get that thing from behind. Oh shit! Oh, he's on our side, okay. No, 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 no zoom, no zoom! Stop zooming! Oh, what the heck was that? See, I can't feel when I'm getting hit. That's weird. I'm used to a rumble when I get shot, and I don't get that feedback anymore. That's another thing that they need to fix. I killed that guy from long distance. Nice. Oops, that's bad aim. Should aim a little higher. Ah. Well, I wasn't trying to say hi to the tanks, but I wanted to blast the tank. Whoa! What did I get hit from? I don't even know what hit me there. I didn't think it was close enough to anybody. Oh, here we go. Got another tank up there. Let's take it down. Where am I? Oh, shit. Let me get closer before I launch my rockets at it. Oh! Damn. Watch those wrist rockets, exactly. Whoa, where did they spawn in? I wanna go outside. Nope, nope. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Oh, I think that one missed. I got slap your mama. Oh, I'm out of rockets. That's the cool part of this. It is fun because it's so damn hectic. There's so many people on the map. Not even pay attention who's around you. There you go. I got hit again. I spawned here, so I'm closer to the tank. The tank's almost out. Right, a couple more wrist rockets and I'll be down. Where are we? Oh, I spawned up here. How did I get... Oh, shit. I got caught by a rocket. Damn. Yeah, let me play catch up. Like, this is what I remember when I was playing as a kid. Just, like, going in a random lobby and playing Conquest or playing Hero Assault and stuff like that. Damn, die! There you go. Ah, shit. Wait, that's on a horse, right? Ah! They really need to fix that. That's jarring. It's not as bad as in the other map, though. No, I couldn't take it down. Whoa, I spawned right in the middle of the battle. Damn. Yeah, I got defeated. Delta Force 2, huh? I don't remember that game. Okay, let's go. Done. Alright, again, random auto assign. Can't pick if I want to be on the dark side or the light side. I just pick whatever side that it's available to me. But I'm, what am I? Oh. I'm the Empire. Oh, at least we're on Hoth. It's a map I remember. Ooh, let me get one of these. How do I get on this thing? There you go. Come on, hit! There you go. Are we taking? No, those are ours. Okay. Those are our guys. Where are the rebels? I just see a bunch of stormtroopers all over the place. They're all on snow speeders? That's gonna be hard. It's gonna be hard to hit those guys on this. Can't even aim that high. See, that's also a problem by having the same stick be the one you maneuver and the one you zoom out of. You accidentally click it. Oh my goodness. Jeez, look at that. Oh, let's spawn right here. Let's spawn under one of these guys. Oh shit. I don't think I'd even hurt that guy. Alright, one's down. Oh, that one's flaming. Trying to use the tilt cables. Not successful, though. Is there a dash? Can you run? I don't remember. Damn, where are these rebels? They're all on snow speeders and nobody's on foot. Oh, grenade. Damn it. Alright, take care, Jimmy. Let me get a heavy guy. Since everybody's on vehicles. Yeah, man, you kind of you avoided one there by not buying this game, man. Unfortunately, I can't say the same thing. There goes another one. Don't get me wrong, it is fun though, but it's just got so many problems. That's not gonna hit. Okay, you take down the generator from it with this thing? Yeah, I think you can actually. No, I think that's our generator, isn't it? No. It's not taking off a lot, though. Uh-oh. Where are you getting hit from? Oh, from behind. Damn. Alright, let's go. Let's go back over there. Our walkers are starting to catch up. Let's see, if we just take over there. They're already starting to blast it. Come on, die. Damn. How did that guy not- oh jeez. How did that guy not die? Oh there, we destroyed it. Let me catch up again. So you're getting a chance to meet up with a celebrity? Okay, who's the celebrity, dude? Am I gonna make a review of it? Well, what happened? Oh, come on! You gotta be kidding me! You're gonna- in the middle of a game, it's gonna crash too? Son of a bitch! Are you serious right now? I was just starting to get in the groove and it fucking crashed on me. Fucking hell. Wait, who wants bison tacos? Venge! Bison tacos and Jimmy wanted bear tacos. Look, man, it's sheep tacos all the way for me. And besides, today's Friday. We can't eat meat. Okay. You pre-ordered Salt Park Snow Days? You know, no more pre-orders for me. Uh-uh. I learned my lesson with this game. No more pre-ordering. If Snow Days is a good game, I'll buy it later on. But I'm not pre-ordering anything else. This is the last pre-order I'm ever going to do. Because I'm tired of getting burned. I'm tired of not being able to pick my matches. Can I join session? Okay, well, pick me another one. Pick a match that's not full. There we go. Band together, we can still win. I mean, I'll probably... I'll tell you this, Melons. I'll probably rent it. I'm not buying it. Oh, it's Hero Saw. Alright, finally. Let's play this beta. Actually, I should have done a Django or Boba better. But I'll go with Vader for now. I never was very good as a Jedi, so I don't expect to be good here. Nope. Let me pick one of the shooters. Let me pick Boba. I mean Django. Let me see if they fixed the blaster. Probably not. I saw Pearl's video about the blaster not working. Or not having the sound effect. Let's find out. Nope, still don't work! There we go, he's down. Yep, the blaster still don't work. What? Black up taco, what? No, I'm the only taco man here. Get out of here. I'm gonna hide behind Jabba. Like, it's the same tactic with whenever I play a shooter with DHC. Hide up behind the Batonkotong. Offers me full protection. Ah. Kenobi snuck up behind me. That's the only reason why that tactic failed. Chris Fossenberg? I don't know who that is, but hey, if he's a car guy, good for you, man. I hope he's a good dude and treats you well. I hope it's not like these celebrities that treat you like a jerk. Where am I? Where did I spawn at? Why am I away from the action? Oh, here we go. Take that, Leia. Oh shit. Oh shit. It is really disheartening that there's no sound effects to the blaster. Damn. You're close to meeting Ken Block. I don't know who that is either. I know your PSN is Ken Block, but I have no idea who that is. Oh, that's a teammate of mine. Okay, hide behind the gigantic Badunkadunk. Here you go. There's no bigger Badunkadunk in the Star Wars universe than what's his name? Oh shit, I forgot this guy's name. What the fuck is your name? Disgusting. He's one of the Huds. I forgot his name. Shit, I am really drawing a blank right now on names. Damn, I'm old. I keep forgetting names I should not forget. Jabba! Jabba the Hutt, thank you. I can't believe I forgot Jabba's name. They just said it earlier. What's wrong with me? See, that's what happens when I only eat my sheep tacos today. I have bad memory. Alright. Where are the good guys? Don't worry, I'm hiding behind the Badunkadunk. Jabba's gigantic. Oh shit! Ah crap, I fell in. Where's the Rancor? No, don't eat me! How do I get out of here? There you go. Okay, the Rancor didn't eat me. Ah! Come on. There we go. Oh, someone got me. Damn it. Jabba the Hutt. I can't believe I forgot that dude's name. It's like Darth Maul. There's Yoda. There's Boba. There's Anakin. Oh crap, what happened? Suddenly I was spazzing all over the place, I couldn't move. Ah, he got me. Okay. But yeah, the fact that the blaster doesn't work is really disheartening. What are these called? Twi'leks, I think? There we go. Oh, jeez. She took us both down. Let me switch it up. Let me be Boba. Let me be the sun now. Whoa! Hey, Boba's works. Boba's blasters work, it's Jango's blaster that doesn't work for some reason. That's weird, it's pretty much the same sound effect. Why would Boba's work and Jango's doesn't? That's weird. Oh jeez, look at the graphics. No, Baby Yoda's not in here. I don't think so. Let me try somebody else. Let me try Grievous. Eat lightsaber. Wait, what happened to me? Why did I get? Oh, jeez. Nope. That didn't go well. Actually, as the Jedi's, I have no idea what I'm doing. So. Well, Grievous isn't technically a Jedi, but. Nah, I'm better off as one of the Bobas. One of the Fets. Boba Fett. Because his blaster actually works, unfortunately for Django. Feed yourself to the Rancor? I almost did. I still got 4 kills. Died 11 times. What's the one in the middle? What's that? That bullseye? What's that supposed to mean? Alright, let's go to the next one. See, again, why can't I choose my team? That sucks. I'm wondering if enough people make enough of a stink of it, if they're gonna issue refunds for this game, for how broken it is. Damn it, don't move. I'm trying to shoot you. Keep your distance. Oh! Oh shit. Ah, damn it. Damn it. Chewbacca, leave me alone. There you go. That's what you get for trying to kill Boba. Snuck up behind me. Okay, that is gonna make me dizzy if I keep seeing that. When that camera goes all crazy on me. Oh, the Emperor. What is thy beating, my master? Jedi scum! Uh-oh. There you go, he's down. Let's take this over. Oh shit. Ah! No, no, no! What are you doing? Stay in your place! Move! What was that? I think we killed him. Here, heal me. Took him to play that game. Shit. Ah, damn it. 2 more spawned in front of me. Damn. Why couldn't we capture that spot? It took forever. Was it because it was just me? Let's see. Something they should have done a long time ago. What did it done a long time ago? Oh, are we talking about the banned accounts? You know what? If you were dumb enough to buy accounts that were like level 8,000... with a bunch of money, you know Rockstar eventually was gonna catch up to these people. So I'm not shocked. You know, I play clean. I don't need to buy my accounts. I grind for my own money. Sorry that you got banned, but now you gotta play the game like the rest of us. Oh, good. Got him. Yes. That was close. I thought he was gonna get me. Oh, Yoda's over there. He's a hard one to hit. He has a major advantage because it's hard to hit him. What the hell? That must have been the force. The force. Somebody must have used the force on me. Damn it! It double teed me. Here, let me follow. Let me follow Django over here. I don't know why you're wasting your rocket on the wall. Keep your distance. Pick him off. Whoa! Uh-oh! Ah! What the hell happened? Why does it lock me in place? Move! I think that was too high. Okay, she's dead. Who else? Who's that? That's Luke? Oh shoot, I'm out of rockets. No, I had three. Why didn't it shoot? Jump! Ah! It's like he tried to get away and it didn't let him. Same of how Django got beheaded. Tried to jump away and it didn't let me jump. What was that glitch? Jeez, this game's a mess. Uh-oh. Did that hit? I don't even know if that hit. Whoa! What the heck? These graphics, man. Heal me. There. Well, I pick them off. Uh-oh. I think that's what's going on. They're using the force on me. That's why I keep, like, glitching out like this. Damn. I don't know why they are just now doing something, but at least they are. Well, hey, man, it's better late than never. I still got 2 kills. Only died 5 times. All right, on to the next one. Still can't pick my team. That's alright, I'm having fun being on the dark side. This game could have been, if they could have just polished, I don't care if the graphics are like this, I don't care that they look old. If they could have just polished the game where the gameplay would have been smooth, and no graphical glitches, and no stupid ragdolling or whatever the hell's going on. And if friends could actually join me. First of all, I don't think anybody's online. Nobody's playing this game right now. What the hell? Move! Oh, it locks me into place. I guess the force power lock keeps me in there. If they can fix that camera, too. That camera's ridiculous. Oh, shit. There's 3 of them. More of them! Ah! Damn. Oh, I think I got Mace, though. I got Mace, I think. Yeah, I got Mace. So I died, but I got somebody back, too, though. Oh, they're hiding on the rooftops. Whoa! Obi-Wan! I gotta keep my distance, though. That makes short work of me. Small Anakin. Oh shit, there's 2 of them. No, move! That damn force power. Well, I'm guessing, Benji, if several accounts got banned, I'm guessing they have one clean account. And a bunch of, like, the accounts that they either paid for or that they got duped. And those are the accounts that that got banned. Well, shit. Get him, Grievous. Yay, got her. Oh. Where are you going? Where are you going, Skywalker? Get over here. Whoa! Join Poppy on the dark side. Come here. Ah! Damn you, you stripper, you! Batman. That's a weird looking Batman. Oh shit, Mace. Oh, he got quadrupled. Oh, he still took out two of the... He took out two moles, damn. Let's see, where are we? Oh, everybody's over here. Shit, let's see if we can take over a spot. I'm trying to get up here. Hold on. There you go. You. Whoa! Damn it, I didn't see little Yoda. I didn't see anybody Yoda over there. He got me. Come here, Mace. Let me blast you. Ah, shit. Super force power. Damn, whenever they grab me and they throw me around, it's hard to know what's going on. I think that's Ventress. Excuse me. Oh, somebody killed Yoda. Good. No, pain in the butt. Ah! Where is he? Okay, somebody got him. Good. We're all the bad guys. I mean, good guys. I am the bad guy. We are the bad guys. Here you go. Get Yoda, get Yoda! Somebody got him. Whoa! I saw that. Somebody trying to get me. Alright, it's a good place to be. Let's just camp up here. Alright, everybody got everybody. Oh, there's another Yoda. Refill droids. I need to restock my ammo. I'm almost out. Let me see. Let me get to one of my our blue areas. I need to restock my ammo. Here we go. All right, where are those refill droids? Oh, they're destroyed. Perfect. I gotta find another one. Or wait for this one to spawn back on. I think they spawn back. Or can I fix it myself? No, I can't. Mm-hmm. You didn't get me, Obi-Wan. What the hell? Okay, I was stuck there for a second. Yay! Good timing too, because I'd run out of ammo. I did a lot better here. 6 kills out of 7 deaths. Let's see what's going on here. Burned by shark guards? No. Benji loves getting griefed in races? No, apparently no. Well, now those people can be, yeah, like exactly like the rest of us. They have to grind like the rest of us. Still can't pick my team. Oh, now I'm on the light side. Oh, that's cool. Let's go with Han. But now I don't got a rocket strapped on me. I gotta be more, a little more careful. Side of the good guys. Whoa. This is not a good place to be when you don't have a rocket, a jetpack. There we go. Like, what am I supposed to do here? I don't have exactly great jumping powers. See what I mean? I just fell in the lava. He spawned somewhere else. Well, jeez, camera. All right, let's see. What the? Ah, somebody's stupid using their stupid Jedi Force powers. I was just stuck in place. Wow. Go to the spawn beacon and change heroes? Can do that? Here's a spawn beacon. There's no option. Whoa! Bunch of Vaders! Oh, how'd I get killed? It has a torch? Yeah, I'll do it. Oh, jeez. Dude threw me off the ledge. Okay, who has a torch? I have no idea who has a torch? Chewbacca, maybe? No, he has a crossbow. Oh, jeez, these graphical glitches, man. Alright, here we go. He's down. Oh, I can charge my shot. No! Where did I end up? What the hell? Oh, that's why they held me in place. Damn, those force powers suck. Han has a repair tool that can be used to repair those robots? Oh, okay. Well, it's a little late now. Alright, well, those robots are destroyed. I don't need it right now. Oh, shit, what did I do? I just jumped off. I didn't mean to do that. Okay, no more fighting in that area. Let's go with Han. Oh, Grievous. Damn it. That is a major disadvantage that they could just toss you around in this map. Oh, gee, the camera just went crazy right there. There we go. Where am I? Oh, geez. I hate when I get thrown around like that. I don't even know by who. Here's a Maul. He got thrown. Oh, no, he's jumping up there. Yeah, I could really use a jetpack right now. How do I get up there? Alright, how do I do the repair thing? What button is it? Is it this one? I didn't do nothing. Whoa! I thought they were bad guys. Oh, there's Vader. I got hit by something. Jeez. Come on. No! Throw me into the lava! No! Jeez. Alright, that is making me dizzy. Wow. Come on, move. Oh, jeez. I'd rather be Boba or Jango, because damn, being Han, it's, you get thrown around. You get stun locked into place. Where am I? What? Oh, I think it was that guy held him in place, okay. Come on, move! Oh, Grievous, you asshole! Okay, that's getting me dizzy. Wow. Ah, we lost. Okay, let me do one more match. -5. Oh, yeah, because I died 5 times, because I fell in the lava 5 times. I just kept getting knocked in there. Come on, let's go. Done. Where's the done button? So I can move on. I'll do one more multiplayer, and then I'll go into the thing that does work, which is the single player. And not even that well, because I hear that the cutscenes are cut out. I don't even know if I want to do that, because, yeah, I just remember that Pro said the cutscenes got cut out in Battlefront 2's single player. Anytime, game. Anytime you want to make me, let me advance. Only thing I can do right now is check out stats. Where's the done button? Come on. There it is. One more multiplayer. We're on Hoth again. It looks like Hoth.
Band together. We can still win.
Okay. Oh, good. Thank you. Back to the bad guys. Boba's my best hope for doing well. And you know, I'm playing with the same people, too. Same people keep joining the same map. Just because there's no other choice. Here they come. Whoa! I don't know if that did anything. There you go, she's dead. All right. Oh, Yoda. Damn it. No, don't. Move. Oh, he almost got me. That was close. How did I miss that? Come on, move. Give me a refill. I can just stand here and pick them off. I don't want to be a camper. I don't want to be a DHC. There you go. Here's one dead. And another one dead. Yay! I killed him. Yay! Another Yoda. Oh shit, Obi-Wan, Obi-Wan, Obi-Wan! Get Obi-Wan, oh! He just threw us around, there's Mace. Need a reload. What is up with that movement? Killed me. I can't even tell. It's not on the kill list. Okay, so no camping, I guess. No DHCing. Ah, how did we get defeated already? That was quick. Oh, he died once. Nice. All right, how do I get out of here? When I don't want to join the one, how do I get out of here? Okay. Victory is within our grasp. All right, let's do this. Let's go back to the launcher. Let's do the first one, because, yeah, I don't want to play the missions for Battlefront 2 if we don't got no cutscenes. My ghetto! So let's try that out for a little bit. And then I'll go on my little rant about this game. If I haven't already. And guys, I'll probably cut it short because, yeah, I really like the game, but it could have been a lot better. For the money that I spent for a straight port that doesn't work, it is really disheartening. Let's go single player. Which one should we do? Clone Wars, Galactic Civil Wars? We can have Civil War. Alright, we'll do the first mission. You tap out. So, Ink says Soap is alive in Modern Warfare 3. It's gonna be hard to pull off when you have a bullet in your head. By Ink, you mean Ink Slasher, right? That's gonna be hard to pull off. I mean, how are they gonna bring him back? I mean, what? How's he gonna survive a bullet to the head? That doesn't make sense to me. I have to look at his video because I don't know what he's talking about. But it doesn't make sense to me. I don't know how they're gonna bring him back. He didn't bite to a bullet on the head. How did he not die from a bullet to the head? I mean, yeah, there might be some occasions where you can survive, but let's say Soap survives the bullet to the head. He's not gonna be the same. He's not going to be a soldier fighting in a war. He's going to be in a bed, comatose, for the rest of his life, probably. Oh, let me read this. It is the time of Galactic Civil War. Rebel spies have stolen the secret planets. The Empire's ultimate weapon, the Death Star. An armored space station with enough power to destroy an entire planet. Planet to planet, the conflict rages on. The Resourceful Alliance strikes quickly, while the lumbering Imperial War Machine looks to crush all the resistance. But this war and vanguards fighting furiously on remote battlefronts. In the far reaches of space. Jeez, I think they could do a better job with the frame rate on the movie clips.
In our search for the missing rebel droids, we have discovered a rebel cell on the planet. In addition, our scouts have come under attack by the natives of Tatooine. Lord Vader has issued an order to eliminate all Tusken raiders and rebels in the Dune Sea area.
Yes, my lord. No. Let's do it. I don't know why I pushed. I shouldn't have pushed circle, but there we go. Also, this is a great logging screen. But I wish the actual sound effect was correct. All right. Let me start with a regular soldier. No, I don't want to go prone. Oh, okay, the controls are a little different in the first Battlefront. I don't think we have a roll button, do we? Or is it another button? No, we don't. And we don't have an aim button either. Get out of here, rebel scum! Ow! Should be a better marksman here, since there's not gonna be any of that lag. There we go. Ah, much better. Get off the, yeah, there you go. Oh, shit. Oh, the Sarlacc pit, gotta be careful. Man, I wish the... Come on. There we go. Ah, you moved, asshole. Stop moving. Oh, there you go. Sorry, that gun. This guy's just standing there. How did he not die? There you go. Any more? I think this is a sniper too, but he's stuck on the sand. Not anymore. Alright, let's see if I can get around the Sarlacc pit. Because there is a little, like, checkpoint right there. We need to capture it. Got him. These guys don't even know I'm here. He does now. Oh shoot, they all do now. I took out several of them, so I did pretty good. Oh, we got one now here, okay. Let me go with the regular one. Okay, where am I? Got one. Hot zone. There you go. Come on. There you go. Come on, lock in. No. There you go. Reload. How did that miss? you just hang in there, buddy. How did I get him? Let me get the ones that are stationary, man. Damn, this thing's too sensitive.
Grenade!
There we go. He didn't die to a bullet in the head, Worley. How did he die then? I mean, he died. I saw him. He took a straight bullet to the head from Makarov. Let me look at that cutscene again when I have a chance. And I gotta look at inside the video, see what he's got up his sleeve. See if I can capture this spot now. There we go. So I was gonna throw a grenade. There's somebody spawning over there. I did pretty good though. Where did I respawn? I don't even know where I am. Okay, there's a Sarlacc pit. Okay, this one. No, don't retreat! Get back over here! Shoot them in their feet. That's close! That's so close! Keep moving forward! No! Rocket to the face, bastard. Can't lose this position. Let me see if I can get a vehicle. That vehicle didn't blow up. What do we got here? We got an X-Wing. God, what is this? Thing all the way over here. Oh, we won! Yay! That was incredibly easy. The frame rate on this movie cutscene is horrible. They couldn't even do the movie part right? Jeez.
Alright, man, load your weapon. Stop that ship! Blast
them! It's barely 1080. But the frame rate is horrible.
Local smugglers from Mos Eisley have escaped with the rebel droids.
I'm not gonna play another mission. It is fun. Replaying these games is a lot of. It is fun. I just wish it was better. But here's the thing about playing the single player game. Get out of there. I have other options if I wanted to play the single player game. Now, let me show you guys this real quick. If I really wanted to, And change the audio. I could just play the single player game here. I have Battlefront 2 here. Change the audio here real quick. So I got Battlefront 2 already on Xbox. Like, I've had it for a while now. I've had it for like a couple of years already. I think I bought it for like $4 or $5. Let's check out the differences here. Now, if you see, it's pretty much the same as the collection. The only thing is no multiplayer because there's no more Xbox Live. This game does not support Xbox Live anymore. But if I wanted to play the single player story, I could. Let's do Galactic Conquest real quick. Birth of the Rebellion. You want to play the training mission first? No, I'll skip it. Would you like to save or save? So if I want to do Collected Conquest, I could just do it here. And look at the graphics. They're exactly the same as the collection. This is the Xbox version. And this is not the collection. This is the OG Battlefront from the OG OG Xbox. I don't know what graphical improvement. Look how actually this looks better. In my opinion, this probably looks better than the freaking collection. It's smoother, it's running at better frames. It still stutters a little bit, but it's not as bad as the collection. Let me drop down. And yeah, it's single player, that's probably why, but still. Oh, wait, these are our guys. Why am I shooting my guys? I mean, how hard could it be to just get this on and add the multiplayer? I don't think it would have been that hard at all. Just turn on the servers again. But graphically, it looks the same as when I was playing the multiplayer earlier. In fact, I think this era looks better.
We've lost a command post.
How do you follow the guys here? I'm not doing my part. Oh, here's an outpost. Capture it. It's ours. Let me get healed up here. Heal me. Actually, I think I even like the zoom here a little better. Yeah, I don't understand either. I don't know. I gotta see in Clash's video to see what the hell's going on. I don't know how. Remembering the cutscene that I saw, he pretty much took a bullet straight to the head. I have no idea how he could survive that. And if he could survive it, how is he like still able to function? But also, I gotta look at in Clash's video, and then I'll formulate my opinion from there. No, oh, what the heck? Alright, we need to capture another command post. Yeah, this way.
We captured a command post. They're losing reinforcements. We've lost control of a command post.
Come on, guys, help me out here. Alright, there's a stormtrooper. Several stormtroopers. Oh shit, a lot of them. Damn it, get away from me!
I
killed a bunch of them, though.
We've lost the command post.
We just needed one more command post.
The enemy is in control of another command post.
Hey, we got this one already. And we lost one. Darn. Oh, it's up there. Okay. Oh, I didn't even, wasn't sure what those were. They were grenades. Yeah, it's gotta find a way to get up there. Oh shoot, this one's getting contested. Get away from me. Get away from my spot. It's mine. Can't have it. Oh my god, come on guys, help me out here. Capture this post. One more troopers arrive. There we go.
We captured a command post.
This is mine.
Enemy reinforcements are declining.
Oh, what? Where did I get hit from? Oh jeez, I'm losing too many.
The enemy has captured a command post.
There I go, I gotta recapture my posts.
Hostiles have captured a command post. We can't keep losing men like this. They're trying to flank us. Get back to the battle, soldier.
Oh shoot, what the hell did they do?
Victory is ours.
Now we're about to win. Just need to kill 11 more. See, imagine now if the multiplayer played like this, man. I'd be having so much fun right now. Because there's no graphical distractions. The game looks smooth, runs smooth. But no. Where's everybody? Yeah, I'll take it. Nobody wants it? I'll take it. Only 2 more soldiers left, that's why. There we go. Alright, we gotta find the 2 soldiers that are hiding.
They're losing reinforcements.
They're not up here. That's ours.
They're losing reinforcements.
There we go. Somebody got him. So if I wanted to play the single player, I could just do it on the Xbox. I didn't have to spend $35. Could just done it right here. So I don't get it. I don't understand why they couldn't just straight up ported this version to the PlayStation. And just integrated the multiplayer. This Battlefront 2 plays much better than the Battlefront 2 that I got on the PlayStation. See, this one is garbage. I don't understand why they gave us this. But they did. They did, and unfortunately, you know, this is the game we ended up with. There was nothing I can do about it. I mean, I hope that they fix it. I hope that they can fix the online so that you can pick what you want to play instead of me just going randomly in the map to map. I wanted to play this with friends. I wanted to be with Pro and anybody else who's a big Star Wars fan and play this game with people. And unfortunately, no, I can't do that because the game is broken online. Doesn't work right. There's glitches all over the place. There's sound effects missing. And even the single player game, I can't, you know, there's no cutscenes for 501. But it's okay. Like I said, I could play the single player game on the Xbox, and it's a much better version. Runs better and is cleaner than this version. I don't know what the hell they were thinking with this one. And here's the other thing. Let me see if this will actually work. Let me switch over real quick. Because I wanted to show something here. Hopefully you guys are able to see it. Let me just look at it real quick. Okay, yeah, so it is visible. So here, I have it on Steam as well. I was dumb enough to also buy the collection on Steam. And the reason why I bought it is because I got it much cheaper than I did on PlayStation. I got it for like $10. So I was like, all right, that's a really good price. I'll just get it from there. So I tried it out. The one good thing I'll say about the Clutch Collection on Steam is that it works really good on the Steam Deck. I loaded it up on my Steam Deck, and it works really well. Like there. I mean, it'll run the same as the PlayStation version. It has the same glitches, same audio issues, same connectivity. But at least I could take it on the go. And that's the one positive I'll give the Classic Collection on Steam. I could take this game on the go. I could take my Steam Deck out. I could go play it anywhere I want. I'll still have the same problems, but I'll be able to do it on the go. Here's the other thing that I don't understand about the Classic Collection. It's Battlefield 1 and 2. Look at the space required. 62 gigabytes of space required to download this game. If you look at the first two, which I have them here as well, because I also have I've had them for a long time. Here's Battlefront 1, 2.8 gigabytes. Okay, that's Battlefront 1. Battlefront 2 is 9.59 gigabytes, roughly 10. Let's round it up to 10. So between Battlefront 1 and 2, the original ones, they're like what? Together with all the DLC, even adding mods and stuff, let's say it'll blow to like 15. Let's say 20 gigabytes if you add the mods and all that stuff for it to look good. Let's say about 20 gigabytes. How the hell did we go from that to 62.87 gigabytes? I don't get that. What the hell is in this game that is so bloated by 40 gigabytes? Like three times this is three times the space needed than the original ones. And you can't say it's a remake or a remaster. There's no graphical fidelity improvements. There's no 60 frames. There's no new assets. There's no new video. There's no new cutscenes. No, the old cutscenes aren't working properly. So where did all this... Where are these 40 gigabytes? What are they for? What's in the game? What did they add? They didn't add anything. The game is broken as fuck. They didn't add anything new. But there's 60... You need 63 gigabytes of space. When the originals, at most, with mods and anything else you want to download, maybe 20 gigabytes for both. But here, the Classic Collection requires 62.87. And this is one of my little pet peeves that I have. I don't understand what the hell. This game is a broken mess. I wasted $45 on two versions that are broken. And that's what pisses me off. Like, I understand, like, Melons, you said that you're happy that it's on your current console. Though, Melons, you could have just played Battlefield 1 and 2 on the Xbox. You didn't have to wait for this. You have an Xbox. You probably have 1 and 2 already, the original ones. That you saw right now, that run much better than this collection does on the PlayStation. If your interest was in multiplayer to play with friends, you could have just played it on the Xbox, the original versions, and they run much better than this load of crap does. I don't know, maybe you wanted trophies. Maybe that's what you wanted. CRM versus Galactic Empire. Okay. All right, Zom. So, you know what? Since I'm here, and I hope it doesn't get claimed, but let me look at the Ink Slasher thing that Melons is talking about real quick. Let me see if I can see that video. Okay, let's see. Slope is alive. We're going to look at this video. I want to react to it. Let me go ahead and do that now. Oh, shoot. I need to hear it too, so.
Yeah.
Let's see this real quick.
The train tunnel, everything that happened at the end of Modern Warfare 3.
Actually, you could, Melons. You just need a capture card. Like I just did right now. See, look. Oh shit, because I was playing this. I'll show you in a minute, but let me go through this this subtext nonsense and let me see what this actually has to do with anything. What do you mean it wasn't in that tunnel?
This is so ridiculous and so out there.
Yeah, I was pausing the mic, but I'll leave it on just because I want to react to it. But I'm sorry if it echoes a little bit.
Ridiculous as it sounds, is alive or not? Before we do, let me tell you about today's video sponsor. So I think it is now official. Today's video is sponsored by the longest running partner of the.
All right, we don't need to see this.
Make a couple of expansion, adding in many more colors and styles for the late.
We don't need the commercial.
So if you go to the link down in the description,
no link.
If you don't like the product, you can just send it back.
No, jeez. How long is this commercial?
Down below, it's a great time to do so. So this all started with Modern Warfare 2019. At the very end of that game, Alex, one of the
volume is off.
Crap. Main playable characters. You go into a scene where you're talking with Barrett, and essentially Alex ends up sacrificing his.
Alright, hold on. Is the volume for me or for the YouTube channel? Is that off? Which one is it? Melons, tell me real quick. If you can't hear the YouTube, then I think I know what to do. But just, I need to know which one's the problem. Is it the video? Okay. Well, let me go back to it. We'll start from the beginning again. And I think I know what the issue is. Hold on. Actually, it's a regular scene. That's weird because it was playing before. Set up there. Let me do it here. All right, and let me know if you see this now. Okay, I think yeah, you can see it. Let me see now. Let me know if you can hear.
Apparently, according to Call of Duty, according to Activision, so McTavish isn't dead, or at least
let me know if you can hear the video.
Wanting us to believe.
And you should be able to now.
Over the past few years, I've made a lot of these videos, and I think that's the reason why on every single one of my videos that I've released over the last month, I have got comments exactly this. Right. And if you don't know what I'm talking about,
let me go through this again. Then.
3, so McTavish is in a train tunnel defusing a bomb with Captain Price when Makarov comes up and quite literally shoots him in the head. You see him die, but recently in season two, a skin for Soap called the Hector Blackcell skin was released.
I don't mind doing
that. And the description of it is, well, I wasn't in that tunnel, referring to him not being there. In other words, he's
like,
alive.
I wasn't in that.
And this
tank
is so ridiculous
Graves.
And so out there. I wasn't even going to cover it, but I kept getting comments. So here we are. Today, we discuss whether or not Soap McTavish, as ridiculous as it sounds, is alive or not. But before we do, let me tell you about today's video sponsor. So I think it is now official. Today's video is sponsored by and essentially Alex ends up sacrificing his life to destroy the gas facility.
We never saw Alex die, so that one makes a little more sense that he came back.
Trigger it himself.
And he lost his leg.
Assumably,
as a consequence to him blowing up that factory in the original Modern Warfare 2019. Modern Warfare.
Seasons of Modern Warfare 2019, he returns a little bruised up, missing a leg.
It makes more sense.
But he comes back, and this tends to be
Graves coming back also makes sense because yeah, we could just say he wasn't in the tank.
Years and years. If you don't,
we never actually saw his body. We never actually saw him die.
Dead. This continued in Modern Warfare 2, where we had the character by the name of Philip Graves. He was essentially an evil character within the game, the leader of Shadow Company. But by the very end, Task Force 141.
Yeah, that's the other thing. He got. It's true. He got cremated.
A gunfight.
They spread his ashes over whatever the hell that area was.
Blow up the tank and assumably kill Graves. But again,
we have a body with
Graves in that tank,
and that body's been cremated. So I wonder how they're gonna retcon all that.
Probably not dead. I said that at the very end of the game.
Let me see what Ink Slasher has to say about it.
Seasons later, I believe it was season 5. Graves makes return, saying this.
Heard you died in a tank in South America.
Yeah, I wasn't in that tank.
Well, I wasn't in that tank.
So when we have a look at what the description of that skin is, for Soap, and it says,
how
well,
not in
that
tunnel.
It's directly referring to what Graves said in that season 5 cutscene. Well, I wasn't in that tank. the exact same thing. But this goes even further, because there was another death that we got completely duped with. Remember how I said if you don't see a character die, they're probably not dead? Well, there's an
CRM versus Shadow Company, all right.
At the end of the Warzone, the Verdansk story, we see Captain Price get in a fight with Viktor Zakayev. In this fight, Captain Price shoots him and then throws him off into a missile silo, falling stories and stories, surely, to his death, right? This is one of the ones where I was like, survived too? Saw him die, he is most definitely dead.
Yes.
Well, as it turns out, not the case. As we find out with the Modern Warfare Zombies storyline, the one to release the gas and cause this zombie apocalypse within Urzikstan is Viktor Zakayev.
Really?
Now, the interesting thing about this is they went on to give a little bit of lore behind this. Apparently, after Captain Price threw Viktor into the missile silo, they went to go look for his body and confirm his death. However, when they got there, they found blood, but Viktor Zakayev was nowhere to be seen. So at this point alone, I was like, okay.
All right, hold on a second. So I haven't actually even played the zombie part of Modern Warfare 3. So are they going to incorporate? I thought that was the non-canon. I thought that was separate from the Modern Warfare storyline. So are they going to incorporate zombies into the Modern Warfare storyline? Is that where we're going? So is Zob going to come back as a zombie? Do we want to go back there? Is that what we want? I don't think so. That's going way into fantasy land. I mean, still, a lot of what happens in Modern Warfare is not really, it's not really realistic, I'll give you that. But this is a little too far. If we're going to go into zombie territory and now there's a virus and all this stuff, I don't know. I don't know if this is where I want to go. Let me continue with the video.
Everyone in this game just has massive plot armor. They're not going to kill anyone, and that is what's going on in this game. And I think everyone kind of.
What about the people that are already dead?
Point. They're just like soap. No matter what you see happen, everyone is safe pretty much all the time, which is a pretty insane thing to say. Move forward to the end of Modern Warfare 3. We finally get the death of a major character that isn't just, oh, something blew up, we didn't see the body. This time, they get shot in the head, we see them die, and even after that, we see our other main characters, like Gaz, Price, and Ghost, have a kind of funeral for Johnny,
aka Sir McTavish.
And we're like, okay, right? He's dead. Now, just a little side piece here. I really thought that killing Soap here probably wasn't the correct move. It didn't make sense with the rest of the story. They didn't build up his character to have extreme emotional ties to really anyone. Ghost was probably the most out of all of them. But really, when looking at this scene, it would have made a lot more sense for the character to pass away to actually be Gaz. Because Gaz kind of was taken under the wing of Captain Price from the very beginning. And to have this be Soap McTavish was way, way less impactful than...
Yeah, because Gaz was introduced in the original Modern Warfare. He was the one that was under the wing of Price. Price would have been more heartfelt if he had lost Gaz, because he'd already been through him since the first game. And so we really just got introduced to Soap in Modern Warfare 2. So I understand that they have this connection, but it's not as well established as it is with Gaz. So Gaz would have made more sense than Soap. But okay, let's continue.
And if someone like Ghost or Gaz was to die during this cutscene, at least that's what I think.
They're in the ashes, so how are they going to retcon that
sentiment as well? So to see him die really wasn't too impactful. But then we see when multiplayer eventually comes out that Soap McTavish is one of the operators in multiplayer in Zombies. But I did a video on this and I kind of explained to you guys that the multiplayer and that
in Zombies. Okay, I never considered Zombies canon to the rest of the story. I saw that Soap was in the zombie storyline, but I just figured that was like Elseworld or alternate universe, whatever the hell they want to call the zombie part of Modern Warfare. But I don't consider that canon to the actual storyline going on right now.
That, on top of that, Zombies actually takes place before the events of the Modern Warfare 3 campaign. So we can kind of be like, okay, Soap McTavish died after all of these battles going on in multiplayer. So that is why he is
So we had a zombie outbreak before the events of Modern Warfare 3? Then why wasn't any of this ever mentioned? That doesn't make sense. That's another big plot hole that seems to be emerging there. That's where they're going.
Point, he then later passes away at the end of Modern Warfare 3. However, we then get the Hector Blackcell skin for Soap, which then says, well, I wasn't in that tunnel. And based off of everything else that we've seen, I wouldn't be surprised if Call of Duty tries to take some spin where either one, Soap comes back as some sort of zombie or something like that, or two, he wasn't actually the person. It was a body double or something dumb like
no,
that.
No, how could you I do a body double? Not, come on.
If we look at some of the other Black Cell kind of quips and kind of comments underneath the names, they are often jokes. So I'm assuming that this is just a joke and callback to Commander Philip Graves from Modern Warfare 2 because everyone thought that was super far-fetched. And I'm assuming that they are doing that here as well. So needless to say, I truly believe that Soap is indeed dead. And
yes,
if they
thank
brought
you.
Him back, I think
I was starting
anything,
to wonder about
it would
your,
take even more away from
your
the
Modern opinion.
Warfare 3 story when it's already very, very lackluster. Moving forward, going into Modern Warfare 4 eventually, like 4 years from now, I'm really hoping to see more drama and more kind of big characters, big names pass away and bring some emotion into the game that's been taken away over the previous 3 years because they were just terrified to kill people within the campaign. At least that's my opinion. So let me know what you're thinking down in the comments. Is Soap dead? Is Soap alive? I truly believe in he's gone. Just that the funeral scene alone has to kind of put the nail in the...
Yes, he's dead. I mean, come on, guys. He's dead. He can't come back as a zombie because that makes zero sense to the story. There are no zombies in the current storyline. The zombie thing is a mode that's outside the story mode. It's outside the campaign. It doesn't make sense for them to bring back Soap as a zombie. Yeah, you can put him in the multiplayer. Put him in the multiplayer you want. Put him as a zombie there. It's just an operator, but it's not canon to the actual story. Not everything in the multiplayer is canon to the actual story. Zombies is not canon to the actual story. So it doesn't make sense. And I'm really, yeah, I am praying also that they save Call of Duty when they do. What is this? What's the one that's coming out this year? Golf? The Golf War one? It's Black Ops, right? Black Ops Golf War, I think it is. Hopefully this year's COD is better than, like, I just want the story to make sense. So at least we're going to give Price and all of them a break, and then we could go to Mason and Woods and continue that story. And hopefully, you know, I do have to play, I have not played the campaign for Cold War. I have not done that. I've had that game forever and I haven't done. The only reason why I downloaded it is because A, it was free. It was part of a PlayStation game. And B, it's because I was playing with DHC multiplayer one day. But I got to get through that campaign. I do remember playing Black Ops back in the day. 1 and 2. Not 3, not 4. Like, 4 didn't even have a storyline. But, yeah. Hold on. Switch back here real quick. So thank you. Who was that? I think Mounds, you were the one that mentioned it, that this Ink Slasher had posted a video about it. It was a good video, but no, he's not alive. He can't come back. Soap is dead. Soap is gone. May he rest in peace. It makes zero sense to bring him back in our current storyline. Zero sense. Actually, there were rumors that they're going to do open combat missions again, according to... No, I hope not. I really, really hope not. Those open, or at least if they're gonna do open combat, do them better. Because there was that one mission on the rooftops was okay. If they could do more missions like that, then okay. But some of the missions I did, like when I remember live streaming, I just bulldozed like dummy through them, like muscle through them easily. So, a Far Cry type campaign, open world, that would be better. See, if they could do something like that. But I really would rather them keep the cinematic versions of it too, like they did with Modern Warfare 3. If they're gonna go that route, 50-50. Have your open combat missions, make them better, make them fun, don't make them trash, but also keep your cinematic ones too. Like the best part about Modern Warfare 3 was the Verdansk mission, where you're in there, you're trying to clear out the football field, and you're trying to find Makarov and all that. That was the best mission in the game. And the best open combat mission was the rooftop mission, where you're trying to like find what's his name, his second in command. I forgot his name already. And stuff like that. And make the story make sense. Like, I know we did a complete 180 from Star Wars to Modern Warfare, but I do have a passion for Modern Warfare. Well, I've been playing it for a long time. I love the story of Price and all of them. And it disheartens me that Modern Warfare 3 was such a crap story. But, yeah. Eventually, hopefully, when Gulf War comes out, whatever they call it, I think it's Gulf War. I mean, it makes sense. Call it Black Ops Gulf War. It's a good name. I'd buy that name. When that comes out, hopefully it's good. Hopefully if they do the open combat missions, they learn from their mistakes and they make them better. They keep some of the cinematic missions. It should really be 50-50. Or at least like 60-40. And hopefully the story makes sense. Like, I know, I do, even though I haven't played the what's it called, the Cold War one, I know how it ends. I know there's a double, there's two endings. There's a good ending and a bad ending. And I think the one that's the continuity is a good ending. So I won't spoil anybody in case I haven't played it. I do have to play it myself because I do want to get the whole story, because I only know, I don't have any context about that ending actually plays out. But it's something I'm gonna do. Alright, so I'm going to end it here, guys. I mean, thank you guys for watching, listening to my rant, watching me play a crappy classic collection of Battlefront. Like I said, it disheartens me that the game was so bad. And I learned my lesson, never pre-order. Never pre-order, dude, because you never know what you're going to get. And I learned that lesson the hard way. It's not the first time I've learned that lesson, but it's a lesson that, for some reason, I didn't take to heart this time. I just let my nostalgia get the better of me. The last time I bought a game, I pre-ordered a game that bit me in the ass, was Cyberpunk. And even Cyberpunk, I didn't get it full price. I think I got it for like $40. So it wasn't that big of a sting, but still. And I was able to get the Xbox version, the Xbox copy, for like $5. After like it was tanked. And after it tanked, then everybody crapped all over it. So at least I got the Xbox version much cheaper. And now it's good. Now the game is great after 3 years. It took them 3 years to fix the damn game. But never again. I'm not even going to pre-order GTA 6, I don't think so. I think I'm going to wait. Unless there's some crazy bonus that they're going to give up, but I don't think there is. Or unless I could get the collector's edition. But that would have to be the physical version. That's the only reason why I would pre-order it. If I could get like the collector's edition. I know that won't be available by the time it releases. But no more pre-orders for me. The only game I will even consider is, like I said, GTA 6. If there's some sort of crazy collector's edition that I need to get. But anyways, guys, thank you guys for watching. Mark, Zom, Melons, and anybody who was already here before, thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for being here. Benj, I know, was here earlier. J-Luke was here earlier. Thank you for putting up with me in this crappy game. I don't know when I'm going to stream next time. My schedule's not open for the rest of this week. I'm going to be busy working, and I got family obligations to take care of. But I'll let you guys know. I'll put a community post or something like that. But thank you guys for watching. Take care. Have a good one. And I'll see you next time. Next time I stream. Take care. And oh, by the way, eat your sheep tacos. Because they're delicious.
My wife is pregnant and I'm about to be a father too.
If I have a daughter, I'm gonna name it after you.
Anyway,
I really hope
this tip will get you through.
Forever yours,
your biggest fan. P.S. We should be together, too.
My dreams are gone, I don't know.